To compare similar texts, you can use ngrams. Here is a challenge for you. But first, what are ngrams? We commonly use phrases like consecutive or in a row. So for example, we see here game of tic-tac-toe, where the winner is someone who gets three in a row. So we play games that we get the same object, crosses or noughts, three in a row. Here's an example of connect four, where we get four in a row. So we play games where we get four in a row as well. We use terms, and the beginning of those terms, we can tell how many it refers to. So when we think of one, we might have a word beginning with uni, like unicycle. Or two, bi, bicycle. So bicycle has two wheels, unicycle has one wheel. Tricycle has three wheels. And when we're talking about vehicles, we might refer to how many wheels they are. So a four-wheeler would have four wheels. So we have like words like universe, unilateral, bicycle, biathlon, bilingual, bilateral, triangle, triathlon, tripod. And the beginning of the word tells us if it refers to one, two, or three things. This is the same with grams. We can think of unigram as one in a row, a bigram as two in a row, a trigram as three in a row, a fourgram as four in a row. If you have more than four, it will be that amount gram. So if it had six, it would be 6 gram, 10 gram. So ngrams are just the amount of something that's in a row, how many consecutive items there are. And we use this with texts, so it would be referring to words. How about using this N? Here we have some dots, so they could be samples. We have a line. To the left of the line, we've named these dots X. And to the right of the line, we've called them Y. How many are there? Well, if we have many samples, we might not really know. We might not know how many samples we have before we start. So we can just say N. We have N dots. Don't know how many there are. We just say N. But in this example, X plus Y will always equal N. Doesn't matter how many dots there are, they'll either be X or Y. So we can use these letters to tell us how many there are, even if the amount actually changes. So if we put them two together, you can see we have ngrams. We have 1 gram, 2 gram, 3 gram, 4 gram, etc. Now let's look at text, and specifically words. Here's a short sentence. Here is a very short sentence. We can look at how many words there are when we had three words in a row, three consecutive words in this sentence. So in this example, there's four. We have here is a very short and very short sentence. So those are trigrams, where we have three words that are consecutive, three in a row, in that sentence. Similarly, here's four in a row. We've got the sentence, here is a very short sentence, and how many times does four words occur? Here is a very short sentence. So in three instances, there are four consecutive words. If we go back to two in a row, how many are there here? We've got here is a very, very short sentence. So that's five. So that's five bigrams. How many times are there two words together? Five. Trigrams, there was four. 4 grams, there was 3. So can you see a pattern here? A unigram is just one word, so if there's 6 words, there'll be 6 unigrams. So let's have a look how many there were. In a 6 word sentence, there were 6 unigrams. 5 bigrams, 4 trigrams, 3 4 grams, 2 5 grams, and 1 6 gram. So you can see there the amount of the n-gram reduces by 1 every time we use a gram that's one size more, how many words there are. So when it's one word, a unigram, there's 6 possibilities. Next one up is a bigram, there's 2 words, there are 5 possibilities. And that goes on until we've got the length of the sentence, which in this case is 6 words, so there's 1 6 gram. So if we would look at different types of sentences, different lengths of 5 words or 6 words or 7 words or 8 or 9 words, we can see here how many unigrams, basically how many n-grams there are. How many n-grams with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6 words. When we put these in a table, you can quite easily see there's a pattern with the amount of grams and the amount of words in a sentence. If we have a look at trigrams, we can see how many trigrams there are in these different length sentences. So how can we calculate how many trigrams are there? Well, we can just use the length of the sentence, how many words is in the sentence, minus 2. So when it's 5 words, trigrams will be 3. When it's 7 words, trigrams will be 5. If there's a 9 word sentence, there'll be 7 possible trigrams. If we select 4 grams, how many 4 grams are in a sentence? We can calculate that as the length of the sentence minus 3. And bigrams, we can do the same. There are as many bigrams in a sentence as words minus 1. So we can see the pattern here. Obviously with unigrams, they're the same as words in this case. So whatever the amount of words in a sentence is the same as unigrams. So how can we use this with 2 sentences? We want to see how similar the second text is to the first text. So here we have 2 sentences. Here is a very short sentence. The second sentence is, there was a very short line of text. So how similar are these sentences? Well, we can look at common words. We had 3 common words. We have a very short. Those 3 words are in both sentences. So we can see here, highlighted in red, very short, in both sentences, 3 words. Now, bigrams would be 2 words together in a row. So we have a very and very short. So we have 2 bigrams that are the same in both sentences. How many trigrams occur in both sentences? Just the 1. We have a very short. Those are the 3 consecutive words, 3 in a row, that happen in both sentences. So that's 1 trigram. How many 4 grams are there? Well, there is none. There isn't a sequence of 4 words that is in both sentences. So there are no 4 grams here. So how do we find n-grams? Well, here we have 2 sentences that are a bit longer. We have, here is a sentence of about 10 words in total. And then the second sentence is another sentence of about 10 words, but it is different. Those are the 2 sentences we want to compare. Now let's have a look at 4 grams. In the first sentence, we've got these 4 grams. Here is a sentence, is a sentence of, a sentence of about, sentence of about 10, of about 10 words, about 10 words in, 10 words in total. So there's 7 times, seven instances where a full gram occur in a first text. So in a first text, four in a row, four words in a row occurs seven times. So and those are the seven examples that happen in the first text. So how many times do the four grams happen in the second text? Well, here's the second text, another sentence of about 10 words, but it is different. We can see sentence of about 10 and of about 10 words happen twice. So there are two four grams that are common in both texts. What about trigrams? Well, here we see all the trigrams highlighted in red, there's eight of them, from the first sentence. So let's have a look. Do they occur in the second sentence? We've got another sentence of about 10 words, but it is different. And there are three trigrams. Sentence of about 10, about 10 words. So those examples where three words together occur in both texts. And we can say those had three trigrams. So that's a measure of similarity. So what is your challenge? Well, we want to calculate how many n-grams there are between two sentences. So we've kind of shown you that already. So I want you to calculate the n-grams, specifically unigrams, bigrams, trigrams and four grams between two texts. So good luck with that. It's easy to do, to test, but can you write the code that does it? So this is the first video in a part two. The second video will go through how to do the coding for n-grams. So we've explained it. Now you're going to test to see if you understand n-grams and can you code that using Python. Well, the answer will be in the next video and that will be coming very soon. So good luck with that challenge. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a like. If you haven't already, please subscribe. So see you very shortly for the next video. Thank you for watching.